Locals refer to it as the hidden treasure of the Indian Ocean. I'm talking about Comoros Island. Maybe it would be interesting to take a tour to the place. In any case, we're joined by the administrator of the National Museum to briefly tell us what we see in what we can see in this museum or in the different islands. Hello, Mr. Ali. What is the Comoros Island heritage? Our heritage consists of ethnographic material, examples being marine and wildlife reserves. We have four showrooms that present a premiere of photographs, ancient sultans, and archaeology. Another room is for volcanology because we are sited on a volcano in Comoros, so we present the different phases of the volcano. And then there is a third room, which is the natural sciences for volatile species like birds. And finally, the fourth room of ethnography, where we present the lives of people on the Comoros Island.
Naguib, there has to be something you're mostly proud of within the museum. And just to add on that, what attracts tourists mostly within the establishment?
We have endemic species. We have a kind of bat called Livingstone found in our islands and also in Seychelles. We also have selaka, a famous fish living in fossil. And finally, there is the Katala volcano, which is located in the largest island. The volcano is said to have the largest diameter. Well, Mr. Ali, in just a word, what characterizes the people of the island? First, we have to know that the Comoros Island, the people of the Comoros Island, as a result of different civilizations, archaeological research shows that before Africans came here, there were lots of foreigners, notably Persians from Iran. They came to colonize the islands. They brought their expertise, the way to build, dress. For example, you can see some similarities in clothing, that of Arabia and Persians, etc., can be found here. But there are also those of African roots. We lodged in the area between Africa and Madagascar, an area called Bantu Swahili civilization. There was also the coming of the Islamization, bringing with it the artisanal craftsmanship.
Entre l'Afrique et Madagascar, dans cette zone qu'on appelle la civilisation bantou, Swahili bantou. Donc il y a eu aussi la venue de l'islamisation, donc à cette époque-là. On peut aussi se trouver dans les savoir-faire artisanal, etc. Donc on retrouve des traces de cette civilisation, Swahili, Bantu.
Well, that was Naguib talking to us about Museology. He's a museum administrator in the country. Well, that brings us to the business end.